We increase the income tax, the sales tax, the tax on cigarettes, and liquor and so forth.
He earned the nickname Spendy Wendy for his tax increases, and tonight he's speaking candidly about his time as one of Minnesota's most famous governors. Wendell Anderson is often remembered for his famous Minnesota Miracle tax and spending plan.
Yeah, he's proud of many things, but also has some regrets about his political career. Tonight, political reporter Tom Hauser talks to Governor Anderson about his time in office.
Honorable Wendell R. Anderson.
Wendell Anderson is one of Minnesota's iconic governors. The son of a packing house worker, he first made a name for himself on the ponds and ice rinks on St. Paul's east side, skating morning, noon, and night.
Incredible ice time. When I went home for supper, I kept my shin pads on and so forth.
He starred for St. Paul Johnson High School, the University of Minnesota, and the U.S. Olympic team that won a silver medal in 1956. But he had ideas about life after hockey.
I was always interested in politics.
At age 25, he won a seat in the Minnesota House. At age 37, in 1970, he ran as an underdog candidate for governor against Republican Doug Head.
Of 125 papers, 123 supported Doug Head, two for Wendy.
But he won again, becoming the youngest governor in the country. He quickly made a mark in Minnesota history as the architect of the Minnesota Miracle.
We increased the income tax, the sales tax, the tax on cigarettes, and liquor and so forth.
The aim was to lower property taxes and increase state support for education, equalizing funding for poor and wealthy school districts.
You got the nickname Spendy Wendy because of this. Did that ever bother you?
No. Because we spent it for a good purpose.
The fact he did that with bipartisan support, truly a miracle, eventually landed him on the cover of Time magazine. For the record, he didn't actually catch that northern pike.
We had what's called a shore lunch. We ate the fish. Now, the fish that I caught have been eaten.
Bolstered by the Minnesota Miracle, his picture on the cover of Time, a 1974 re-election where he carried all 87 counties, his political career was soaring. In 1976, Walter Mondale was elected vice president, creating an open Senate seat. Polls showed Anderson as a popular choice to replace Mondale. But that led to a politically fatal move. Anderson resigned as governor so Lieutenant Governor Rudy Perpich could become governor and appoint Anderson to the U.S. Senate.
In retrospect, do you have any regrets about that?
Only about 100%. You know, you're absolutely, it was a mistake.
That move is largely blamed for the so-called Minnesota Massacre on Election Day 1978. Voters punished Anderson and Perpich, sweeping Republicans into the governorship and both U.S. Senate seats. So with both a Minnesota miracle and massacre on his record,
what do you want people to remember about your public service?
That the I have three very, very normal children and four perfect grandchildren and more to come.
Wendell Anderson celebrated his 80th birthday last month at Wayzata Country Club, a day that Governor Dayton declared Wendell Anderson Day in Minnesota.